In Asia and the Pacific region, the biggest challenge, number one, is population. It's the most populous region, more than 60% of world population, 4.5 billion people. So we have 4.5 billion customers, which need water, which need energy, which need food, which need education, and very importantly, health facilities. So in that regard, we have many challenges. And also this is the region which has many disasters, especially disasters related to floods, droughts, tsunamis, earthquakes, so anything you can imagine about. And all these issues can only be solved if we can use innovations in science, technology, as well as look into how can we bring people together, how can we have the empowerment of women in this region. So, with those challenges, what excites me about UNESCO? UNESCO's comprehensive mandate in education, in science, but also very importantly linked with culture, linked with communication and information. If we bring all those mandates of UNESCO together, then we can use UNESCO sites, the MAB program, the World Heritage Sites, the UNESCO river basins, and then we can also bring together the governments at all levels, the local government, the provincial governments, the national governments, and that will help us with what we call the 2030 agendas and how can we bring science into having more efficient services for the people. And there are many good examples already, which excites me that now we can propose those examples to the governments, how can we upscale them to whole of the region, and UNESCO becomes a leader in bringing innovation in sciences and technology, at the same time also bring local and indigenous knowledge. So this is exciting time for UNESCO, and this particular meeting gives us the opportunity to bring everything together. Thank you very much.